Hey, what's up, everybody? On a gorgeous day here on the North Shore of Oahu, being joined on the field here at Kahuku High School by Red Raiders head coach Lee Leslie. Hey, not too bad. 3-0, haven't lost yet as head coach. Things are going pretty well so far.
Yeah, winning's not overrated. We'll take as many of those as we can get.
You come from, at least your last stop, being in Kuna, Idaho. What is the lifestyle transition like coming to Kahuku from some of those previous stops?
Well, I always said faith, family, football, and food, and I've had some amazing food. Everywhere I go, there's food. It's been good. It's been a lot of fun, and these kids are really rewarding to coach.
How would you describe this offense that Kahuku is running here in your first year? You have players like Tuli Wailimatangi at quarterback, Kesi Ahoy, who is a dual threat guy out of the backfield. You can line him up. But how would you describe this Kahuku offense?
You know, it's wide open, and it's capable of going very, very wide open. But a lot of it will depend on what we need each week. You know, one thing you can do at Kahuku is run. And I've got three 270-pound fullbacks that can run and block. And then Kesi, to me, is one of the most unique young men, you know, on the planet right now. He can get up and go. And if he'd have been given half the carries he should have gotten, you know, I'd pull him off the field at halftime, but he probably has some enormous stats right now. But he doesn't care about that. He knows, he sees the big picture, and he's only a sophomore, but he sees the big picture already, so I couldn't be more impressed with him.
He had a very unique upbringing, very unique background, but you say that that's has a lot to do with the kind of values and discipline that you try to instill in your players and your students as a teacher. Talk a little bit about just the process of becoming the person that you are and the values that you have attained.
You know, I was raised by grandparents. You know, my mom died the day I was born. I was in an orphanage for a couple of years of my life, and that's what I enjoy teaching more than anything else, is high character standards. I think kids nowadays, I mean, these stupid things right here, you know, these phones, it really comes down to us as leaders to make ourselves available, strategize and do youth camps like we did last week and make ourselves available, and kids will be out here. We just got to give them a reason to get out you know, good language, proper morals, doing the things that they're expected to do when their mom and dad are standing right here watching them. And that matters to me. It matters a lot. It matters a lot more than football, to be honest with you.
Well, it's an enriched tradition, and 3-0 to start the season. Pretty darn good start. Lee Leslie, continued success here the rest of the year.
Well, thank you very much.
All right, that's it for Leahey's Locker Room. Send it back to the studio.
Thanks a lot, Kanoa and Coach. All right, fellas, it is that time of the night, giving out plate lunches and slushies from our friends at Rainbow Drive-In. Brian, who's getting your two scoops tonight?
Sending my two scoops all the way to the other side, to the founders of Hawaii Athletes in Action, Ana and Lua Tui Asasopo. They take a group of kids from Hawaii, they do a college tour, and you know what? They do it every year, and sometimes they fork it out of their own pocket. So this one's for them.
Well deserved. Sammy, who's getting yours?
My two scoops going out to Chantel, T.R.A. Tom out at Waianae High School. New band teacher out there. Now, they haven't had a band in about 5 years. Some instruments lost, etc. So they're trying to build the program back up. And she's got them going for the homecoming game up on September 19th. They're going to get the alumni back together, some new students together to get the band out for the players. And you got to have a band out there, right? That's the thing about high school football, get the rhythm going.
That's awesome, awesome stuff. My two scoops going to Cody Look, daughter of Iolani head coach Wendell Look, an administrative assistant with the Arena Football League San Jose Sabercats. She was instrumental in bringing the team here for this Sunday's open tryout at Iolani School. For more info on that and to register, all you former Hawaii high school standouts, you want to get into the AFL, check out our website, khon2.com. Sammy, your plate lunch looks a little light.
Oh, yeah, man. You know, I'm kind of thin. I get hungry sometimes.
Open that thing up, B. Open that up. Open that up. Come on, man. You cannot give out a plate lunch.
And he ate it.
That has already been eaten.
So
come
I'll
on,
you, I'll
Sam.
I'll get you back, okay? We'll go to Rainbow.
Mine is still here. Still
Cody,
here.
You got yours.
There
look
we
at
go.
That. Look at that. Brutal. Brutal.
Won't make it past the tunnel.
Come on,
Rainbow's
Sam.
Is too good. I couldn't help myself. You look, I didn't eat yours.
That does it for us. Be careful. If you're around Sam and you got
this
food, be careful.
Beach.
For Sam Spangler, Brian Te'o, Kanoa Leahey, Coach Thane, Uncle Bruce on the Big Island, and our entire Cover 2 crew, I'm Rob DeMello. Thanks for watching, everybody. Aloha.
I got your back! Covered.